to see young school children with high matured minds. That is my reading of you today. So intense, with high concentration to listen to my speech. And the enthusiasm with which you see me is very profound. I welcome you all and wish that speech of mine today will propel you to greater heights, not only in writing your exams, getting good marks, but also in your journey, in your life. And I pray and wish that all of you here, will be definitely achieving the Himalayan pinnacles of glory in your respective fields. Because you are fortunate enough to be here and to receive and listen to such lectures, whosoever it may be. Because I am very glad that this school, Sivaswami Kalalaya School, is encouraging such type of lectures out of class systems and methods, which forms part or a major part, which plays a major part in education systems. The most important thing is sitting inside the class, learning the books, attending to class teachers is one way. But to have a motivation within you to learn something outside the curriculum or those methods which also help in the curriculum and also for your future life, these are all very important aspects. I'm very glad that such schools exist. And this is going to create our society. Young students, you form the backbone. You are going to create future India in a much, much better way. And I would say many a time better than those Western nations which have taken a lead over us over the last 500, 600 years when compared to our Vedic civilization, where Indians, where the people living on the river, on the other side of river, Sindhu, Hindus, were the greatest of the great leaders. We lost that. But now we are going to gain, and we are gaining that. I can see that through my foresight. Well, I will stick on today to my principal topic. That's the main topic. How to overcome fear while writing your exams. This construction itself, the fear, is a negative energy. There is nothing called fear. Fear is the imagination of your mind. Absolutely, please do not think anything of fear. There is nothing called fear in this world because the universe is vast. The universe you live in has got abundant energy, the cosmic energy. Each one of you can derive those energies and each one of you can propel yourself to commanding heights. Each one of you can be Einstein in physics. Each one of you can be a Tendulkar in cricket. Each one of you can be a big singer, a Beethoven in music. Each one of you can be a Srinivasan, Ramanujam or Thomas Harvey in mathematics. Each one of you can be a Thomas Alva Edison in engineering, in inventions. Each one of you can be a Bill Gates or a Steve Jobs in computer science, because each one of you have got the potentiality. I'm not just talking out of my mind, but I will substantiate what I'm telling you. I'm going to substantiate because each one of us has got our divine. Asau Vadityo Brahma, Brahma Iva, Ahamasmi said the Vedas. This which you argue as Brahma, I am that. That means you all know universe is infinite. The power of the Brahman or the power of the Almighty is infinite. If Almighty is infinite, Almighty is going to be everywhere. Thunilim iruppar, thurumbilim iruppar. He is going to be inside the room, he is going to be outside the room, he is going to be inside you also. If Almighty is powerful and Almighty is within you also, you are also powerful. A equals to B equals to A equals B. Simple concept. There need not be any other concept other than that. This is a very, very simple basic concept. The entire universe sprung up from an infinite dot, says the NASA scientist. What is an infinite dot? Infinite means smallest of the smallest of the smallest dot. There is no explanation. From a very small dot, if a big universe consisting of billions and billions of stars, planets, gases, ecological structures everywhere is formed, how many infinite dots do you have in your brain? Your brain consists of about 80 billion to 100 billion neuron cells. 80 billion means 8,000 crores. 100 crores is 1 billion. So many cells you are possessed of, then what is the power of each cell? Each cell can create an universe like this with 100 billion galaxies, each galaxy having 100 billion suns. Then why don't you exploit that power? Why don't you say, I am not able to do that? Why you say? That is a negative energy. That is, you are coating yourself with negative thoughts, thinking of an inferiority, complex situation. You are not able to come out of the shell and think that you are the biggest of the big. Because you are imbued with that negative thought. Dr. Milioni, the recent Nobel Prize winner, said, at any zero point in vacuum, in any given volume, the zero point in a vacuum has energy that is infinite. In a vacuum of any volume, this size volume or this size volume or the universal volume, the zero point there in any vacuum of any given volume has infinite energy, he says. It's a proven concept. Just like an infinite dot created the universe. That means so much of potential energy is there that we are not able to exploit because of negative thoughts. A 40 watt bulb, if the light is laced properly, a 40 watt single bulb standing alone there on the road or outside this auditorium can give out heat equivalent to the surface heat of the sun, which is 6000 degrees centigrade. A single kilo of coal, said Dr. Einstein, if burnt properly, can give energy or can light up entire America for 2 months. A single kilo of coal, whereas I use that or we use that for cooking a pot of rice. So much is the abundant energy available in this universe. So much we are blessed with. Aham Brahmasmi. That we don't realize that we are blessed with. We don't tap that infinite potential energy available within us to its maximum capacity. We cloud, we throw cow dung on the diamond. The diamond, how it will shine if you throw a cow dung? You are deliberately, by creating by your own imagination of fear, you smoke it. You cloud your bright, powerful brain with cow dung and smoke. How will that revel? How will that exploit itself? How will the explosion take place? You are afraid. You are free. You are fearful. You are fearing what? You are fearing about a simple test or an exam that is going to come tomorrow. You think of that exam when the dates are announced on March 1st. That is my board exam. Immediately stomach flies. Butterflies creep into your stomach. You are afraid. Not you all, some. You may be or may not be. But there is some sort of a negative fear. Oh, my exams have been announced. I have to go. You imagine the examination hall. You start shivering. You enter the examination hall. You see the supervisor. You see the question paper. You start shivering. Now, why you fear? Fear because what is fear? Your expected result of yourself may not come. You get a disappointment. You fear of a disappointment within yourself. The event has not happened. You are basing that examination fear on past event or some current instances and then projecting it towards the future, so that when the examination is announced next week or next month, You think you manufacture a fear that you will not get good marks, that the questions may not be correct, and if you don't get good marks, you will not get into IITs or engineering institutions, or your mother will scold you, your parents will scold you, your teachers will scold you, your peers, your friends will mock at you. You create all these cowdung imaginations. You create all this smoke. You create yourself when you are a diamond, when you are the blessed one, when you are the divine power, you smoke it. You smoke yourself, imagining something, imagining a ghost in the darkness. In olden times they will say, don't go into the darkness because there is ghost. Where is the ghost? It is only in your mind. The ghost does not exist. There is absolutely nothing for you to fear of writing an exam when there are much greater events, greater happenings that is going to take place in your future life. What is there to fear for the exam? What is there? Simply your own imagination you create. Now what happens when your mind gets smoked? The diamond in you doesn't shine. The talent in you doesn't shine. That means your memory will get absent. Your memory may not produce. You will get flummoxed. You will get perplexed. You may be the brightest student, but the fear, the cancer, it overtakes you. You should know something about brain before I talk of, I go further. You see, the brain has about 80 billion neuron cells, I told you. That's called nerve cells. You must have read by this time, most of you in science. 80 to 100 billion cells is what 1.2-1.5 kilo of human brain has. Now each neuron cell is connected to each other, and each neuron cell has got what is known as axons, the body cell, and at the end it's got the dendrites. It's very, very small. It's easy to explain, but you have to see with powerful microscopes only, because there are 8,000 crores of neuron cells in your brain. Now these axons are one cell. The another neuron cell also has the same axon, the same body cell, and the same dendrites. Fortunately or unfortunately, the system is such that one axon faces the other dendrites. That is, one cell faces the other cell on the opposite way. The axon of one cell at one end faces the dendrite of the other neuron cell on the other end. That is, axons spew out information, dendrites receive that information, and they pass through our brains like that. Simple. In between those two cells, two neuron cells, we have a small space called synapses. Now, for you to be intelligent, there should be a free flow of information from one neuron to the other. Mind you, from one neuron cell of your brain to the other, it should not get clogged. It should not get blocked. Just like your artery is getting blocked and a man is having heart attack, same way, your neurons, one neuron to the other, should be clean and free. Now, if you have fear, which is a negative emotion, what happens? Pus cells form. Your simple, faked imagination that you may not get the correct answer or that you may score low marks is a simple fear. Even without seeing the examination paper, you fear. And then what happens? That fear causes pus cells, emotions, and they block the synapses, the space between two neurons. When such blockage takes place, the free flow of information is arrested. When it gets arrested, you are not able to function properly. Now, who caused that? You are prepared well. It is your own imagination. It is your own imagination of a fear that is not there. You create yourself, get frightened, and what happens? It blocks your neurons. And what is going to do good for you? It will cause loss of memory. What happened to Arjuna? Who was Arjuna in Mahabharata? All of you know. One of the skillful archers the world has ever produced. He only saw the bird. He didn't see the branches. He didn't see the leaves. He didn't see the trunk of the tree. Neither did he see the tree itself. He saw only the bird perched on the branch of a tree. And then with what is known as a pinpoint accuracy, his arrow struck and Dronacharya was pleased. He and Ekalavya. But then Arjuna, what happened when he came to Mahabharata war? Fear took him. Chanchalam me manaha Krishna pramadi balavadridam tasya nigraham manye vayo rivasa dushkaram. Hey Krishna, get lost. I'm not going to fight. Sanchalam me manah Krishna. My mind is agitated. Chanchalam. My mind is perturbed. Sanchalam me manah Krishna pramadi. Pramadi means agitation. Balavaha dridam. Dridam. Strong. Balavaha. Firmly. Tasya aham nigraham manye. Nigraham means take out. Graham means taking in. Take out. Nigraham manye. Because vayo rivasa dushkridam. Vayu means a very big storm. Kodungatri. Adaivida. Adu dushkaramagi. The hand of the vayu is better than the sanchalam which is in my mind. I am not able to fight. The greatest of the greatest archers simply threw away his bow and arrow and sat. Weakened. Entire body was weakened. His entire skill was weakened. For what? Who created that? He himself created. Then Bhagavan gave him the dosage of psychology. So what I am saying is, the fear of writing an exam is no fear at all. Why should you fear? What is there for you to fear? If you have that mentality will spoil you. Simply there is nothing called fear. Throw it away from your mind. I will tell you a classic example. Once I went to Kerala. I am from Kerala, a place called Trichur. In a huge field, I saw big elephants standing 20, 15, 10 feet high. They were tied to a rope. So I asked the Mahal, hey, such a big elephant you are tying it to a chain. Can you not simply pull it and run? He's so big. He can even pull lorry loads of logs. Then the Mahal, the wise man, told me, sir, when the elephant, the calf, when he was a calf, when he was a one day, when he dropped out from his mother's womb, at that time itself, I used to tie his leg in a pole. So at that young calf, at that young age, when he tries to pull, he could not break the chain at that young age of a day or 1 hour or 2 hours. So that mentality he carries on even when he grows. He thinks that he cannot break the chain even when he is 10 years old or 15 years old. Because that has been indoctrinated in his mind by nature or by his practice. And that the powerful elephant cannot even simply break a small rope when he is 20 years old or 15 years old in 10 feet high. What does it show? This shows the negative thinking. If it is indoctrinated, a fear is a negative thinking. A fear is a negative energy. If it is indoctrinated in our minds, the ability to give the best result, the ability to give the fullest potentiality, the ability to give 6,000 degrees.